Hey everybody, it's me, Carrie. I am setting up my screen and hoping that this time it will let me see your comments. I don't know why it's being so stinky lately, but it is. So let's, oh, there it did. It flipped again. I don't know why it keeps flipping. I don't want it to. It wasn't doing that, and then all of a sudden now it is. So hello to whoever's watching. I think that's Amber's picture, but it's so tiny on my phone. So say hello and, thank you for watching. So I have these cards out because I posted about that special paper pumpkin that's available, right now. And there's something on there. Oh, well, I'll get it later. Looks like my cat's been walking on the desk. Anyway, I wanted you to see the cards because they are so beautiful. And it's under $10, not including shipping. Hi, Pamela. So this is the one of the cards. And look at the, even the envelopes are just so beautiful. So there's one. Here's the other one. And it's gorgeous envelope. They're just, oh, and this one, you know, I want to say it's my favorite, but honestly, all three in this kit are so freaking beautiful. This is all one big background piece, and then you add stuff over it. I think, yeah, oh, it's just, it's so, so gorgeous. So I wanted you guys to see it because these are so beautiful that when I made my kit, I had to keep three of them, you know, one of each one, because I just couldn't, let it go because it's just, it's so beautiful. So, anyway, I wanted you to see those. Okay. So today for Saturday Sip, we are going to do something just quick and fun. As you guys know, I've got a lot going on. I'm trying to get ready for Mega Meat. So I wanted to use something that I really like that is retiring, and that's the In Bloom set with its amazing dyes. I keep trying to decide if I'm going to let go of the dyes. They're just so cool. But anyway, the stamp set right now, it's on the goodbye rack. So the stamp set is 17. The dyes are 37. But they're on sale for $18.50. To my knowledge, when I last checked, they are both still available. But you know how that goes with retiring stuff. So if you like this, you're going to want to snatch it up. Definitely the dies. I mean, I think the stamp set is really cute, but definitely the dies. And let me show you why. Because these are some of the dies. Let me see if I can match them up for you. There's that one and that one. And I didn't even use them all. And that one. And then I think there's two of those. I used two of those. And then I know this is here somewhere. Anyway, there's this one. And then there's another one of those. So I did a couple of those. A bunch of this. Adorable. And can you see how they all have stitches? And then there's a stamp that punches two of these, or cuts two of these little flowers that have the little holes. So what I did for this card was I just punched a whole bunch of them because I am gonna wing it with this one, because I saw someone do a similar card and I just thought it was so cute that I decided to kind of case it from memory. So it's not going to be exactly like hers was. So this is some retiring designer series paper that I grabbed. And it is, I didn't measure because that would be logical, right? So let me grab my ruler. So this is 4 by 5 1/4, and it's going to be the card front. So this is 5 1/4 by 1 3/4. I think though the depth you have, this is totally a personal opinion. So this is just going to set on there as kind of a base. And I'm just going to slide it in place. There we go. Okay, so simple, right? Now I have a sentiment out, but because I'm playing, I don't know if I'm going to use the sentiment. I may wait and save it for the inside. But this is where the fun starts. I'm just going to start playing with different flowers and decide where do I want them? Where do I think I want to have them? So, and the leaves and stuff. So I'm just sort of flittering around here, and I may not use them all. I don't know. See, I don't know. Maybe I'll put that one down here. Then I've got these little guys that can float somewhere and fill in. And then I've got leaves. So I'm just trying to kind of get an idea. What do I want to do with this batch? Now, the leaves, there's two. Look at this. There's two different dyes. So you've got one that curves one way and one that curves the other, which I love when that happens because, you know, I didn't want it to go this way. I wanted it to curve into the card. So, you know, if I put that there. Now, this is how I design, you guys. I just play around. And obviously, when I put them in, they're not going to go exactly where they want. There's also little leaves like this that are just like little twofer leaves because there's two of them. And I'm just going to see what I can see with what I want to do here. So that's a lot. That's like a lot of stuff on here. So this is where I have to decide. So I'm going to start with these leaves on the bottom because I know I kind of want those. So I'm going to just go ahead and use some of my liquid adhesive on these. And I don't know how this is going to come out, you guys. I don't. I've got a memory of how the card was that I saw that I really liked. And I'm just sort of winging it. Because I want it to be fun. Do you guys do that? Let me know that I'm not the only one who does craziness like this. Now, one of the reasons to have this one here is I kind of want to hide that the change in the paper to the white. And see, that just kind of hides it a little bit. Now, I am going to place this one down flat. Hi, Joan. How are you? Hey, Joan, the catalogs are in. I just haven't had time to stamp them. So I'll be letting you and Lori know pretty quickly so you guys can pick them up. And then I think I had one of these up here. And I'm just sort of building. Now, you're going to look at this and go, you are so not a gardener. Yep, that's true. I am nowhere near a garden type person. Wish I were. I love flowers, and I look at, like, my idea of the perfect garden at my house would be like one of those English gardens, you know, where like your whole yard is full of flowers and there's all over the place and it's like a beautiful mess. But in my world, it would just be a mess. There'd be no, the beauty would be gone. Okay, so I'm going to take this one and I'm just going to do one stamp and dimensional on it because I'm going to want it to sort of pop up, and I'm letting it hang off a little bit because I know it's going to go on top of this. I'm trying to remember what color I used. I think this is Poppy Parade. No, this is a new in. These are all new in colors. Ah, so this is Sweet Sorbet. So these are all new in colors. How could I forget that? Oh my gosh. So I'm using all of them, which is just really cool. I'm going to tuck that one under there. So, like so. And then this one, I might pop up over and put it down here. another one. And you can see I'm just having fun. And isn't that what we're supposed to be doing, you guys? Is kind of having some fun with our product. It's just so much easier when you're playing and designing at the same time. Now, I don't know why I'm worried about those reds being together. The sweet sorbet next to the sweet sorbet, but I worry about silly things like that. And I'm going to put that one there. It's kind of covering up the leaves, so maybe I will stick it here. Then I have another one of these dark ones. You guys, I should know these names, but I don't. I'm going to be honest. I'll know them in a little while, but I don't know them all yet. We know this one because we're calling it Carrie Bickblau, right? Because it's one of the languages looks like my name. It's Tahitian Tide. I know that. Because it's my favorite. Hi, Amber. Somebody said something. Ask Lori. She has a green thumb. Yeah, I know. I know Lori does. She's like an amazing gardener. And she's a good crafter, too. So, you know, kind of got to love her. Just going to let that guy float over here. Let's see. Do I want to give him some leaves? Oh, why not? So you can see I'm winging it, and you guys saw me kind of set it up, and it doesn't really look like the way I set it up either. So I may have to trim that, but I'm okay with that. And then there's one more of these, which I think I will just put. Right here. I'm going to tuck him under there. There we go. But isn't that pretty? And it's so fun. And I'm hoping you guys can see how they've all got the dimension. Now, you could pop some rhinestones or pearls or something into the center to bling it up. I did leave myself enough room to stamp a sentiment, which is from the In Bloom. I'm going to stamp "You Mean So Much to Me." I think that's the one I grabbed. Nope, I grabbed "You Are Amazing." Because it would be good for a birthday, it would be good for a thank you. And so, there we go. "You Are Amazing." And then fold my card in half. Of course, you're going to want to put some basic white on the inside. But these new In colors are so pretty. And what you can see when you use them all together, they're just so happy. I don't know why I'm squeezing funny today. So, there we go. That is my simple card. Do you guys like it? I just think it's so, so fun. And I wanted to use these awesome dies one more time before. See, this is hanging off. You know, I'm going to see if it'll fit in an envelope. If it doesn't, I'll trim it off. But otherwise, I'll just leave it hanging off. But I really want to promote these dies because for $18.50, they were $37. So that's like, you know, less than half, or that is exactly 50%. And so I wanted you guys to see them. There's a label. There's a stem so you could like make your flowers grow. There's a little bow here. There's little like somebody called them eggs, but I think they're actually supposed to be like flower centers, and there's smaller flower centers and lots of different leaves and a burst, and there's just so much. I mean, this is isn't this amazing, you guys? It's so amazing. So if you're into dyes and you like to do this, and it doesn't take that long, and they're so dimensional, you don't really have to do anything. I mean, I popped them up, but you saw me create this card right in front of you. I mean, I had the pieces, I had a general idea, I knew the card that I was copying, and there you go. Super, super simple, right? So, okay, I hope you guys have a wonderful and blessed Easter weekend. What a glorious thing to celebrate. Praise the Lord, He has taken good care of us. And I'm wishing you all the best. If you are not Christian, maybe you're doing Passover or Ramadan. Just know that you are in my heart this wonderful holiday, combined holiday. I mean, that just doesn't happen very often, so it's kind of cool. Anyway, so I will see you back on Tuesday for another tiny tip. Thanks, Amber. And I will be, I'm doing so much for Mega Meat. Like I said, I'm trying to get some kits together that I think you guys are going to love. One of the kits is, there are technically four different cards that are going to be in the kit, but one of them, you will have enough stuff to make the same card four times. And there's a reason for that, which you will see. And if I sell enough, we will turn that into a bingo. And that will be during party week. Woohoo! So I'm still trying to figure out how to do party week, you guys, because technically the catalog starts May 3rd. So that's only in a couple of weeks, right? So, but May Wednesday, I think May 3rd is a Tuesday. Yeah, I think bling would be pretty too, Susan. I think it would be pretty. I just didn't add it to this one because you don't have to. And there are dies that you could cut out for the center if you wanted to. But anyway, on Wednesday is when we go set up for Mega Meat. And so normally my party week would start Tuesday and run through, right? But Wednesday I'm setting up, and then Thursday, Friday, Saturday is Mega Meat. So it's going to be crazy. I think you guys saw, I'm taking my wheel to Mega Meat. I will be giving away, everybody will get to spin who places a minimum new product order. It doesn't have to be new stuff, but something from the annual catalog. And I think probably for a minimum purchase in the booth, they'll get to spin and win some fun prizes. So I'm excited about that. I will have the wheel, of course, for party week. You guys know I would never do party week without the wheel. I am going to be taping some videos so you guys have some things to watch. And of course, I'll be doing some live stuff from Mega Meat as well. Oh, Joan, I'm so sorry you're missing Mega Meat. But, you know, it's every year, so you can come back. Joan doesn't live very far from me, you guys. Anyway, what else am I going to tell you? I don't know. My brain is like, go here. So, anyway, I will see you back here on Tuesday. I don't know if I will be live or if it will be taped, but I'm going to start showing. I've got some product that I want to show before it goes away, if it doesn't go away. And then I want to start showing some new products so you guys can start getting your orders ready for May 3rd and party week. So even though party week may start after the catalog goes live, I'm going to be doing, you know how I do the orders and you get prizes for orders. May 3rd, you got your catalog, you see it online, whatever. Hi, Kay. Your orders are going to count. There will be a new hostess code, so watch for that. I will pop it up so you guys have it. So watch for that. It'll be pinned at the top of my Facebook page like it always is. So, okay, you guys, have a wonderful, wonderful weekend. I hope that some of you are staying warm. It's pretty chilly here in Michigan right now, and we are expecting snow next week. Yay! So have a good one. Bye, everybody.